Hey, what's good, Coach Colin Castello with Shot Mechanics Basketball. In today's video, I'm going to give you the best combo moves to help you embarrass defenders.
Second most points for a Boston Celtic before turning 22. And he's going to pass Antoine Walker. Jaylen Brown getting it done.
All right, so in today's video, we're going to go over some of the best combo moves to help you not only break angles, but embarrass defenders and get fantastic offensive looks. A lot of players work on one move and one move at a time, but when you start comboing it together, that's when you start getting really fantastic results. So that's what we're going to do in this video. But make sure you watch to the end, because I've got something 100% free that's going to take your scoring average to the next level that you're not going to want to miss. All right, so the first combo we're going to talk about, we're going to do a drag pullback into a scissor step. So basically, a drag pullback is just like a normal pullback where you're yanking the ball back, but this time I'm gonna put it between my legs and go to my opposite hip. So this works well out of a catch in an initial drive situation, maybe transition. All we're trying to do is we're trying to drive first, open his hips up, and then yank the ball back. So now that you see I've got this space right here, right? The second part of the combo is a scissor step where I'm going to palm the basketball up here with my, or pocket the basketball up here with my palm facing down, maybe a little bit towards the back. I'm gonna hover the ball up by my armpit, and as I do, I'm going to scissor my feet or chop them opposite, and I'm going to stab and drop my shoulders that direction. Now from here in the combo, I wanna read what he does. If he gives me space, it might be a pull-up. If he jumps that jab, it might be a crossover, right? If he really kinda pressures me, it might be behind the back. I wanna read what he does, but the combo allows me to play off of that first move, right? So as I come through and I yank it and I scissor, as soon as I get here, if he goes there, boom, I've got open space to go to the opposite side. So really sell that pullback hard, scissor, and then just wait and see what he does. Now the whole key here is that pocket, like I mentioned. So when we yank this back, we gotta make sure that the ball comes up and I keep my hand on top and let it spin like this so I can essentially wait for the right moment to manipulate it, go by him or pull up or whatever I wanna do, right? So the drag pullback to the scissor, ooh, you're gonna get a lot of great looks, and a lot of times you can get a defender to fall if you do it right.
Started on the ground, I'm working in the basement. Made it to the attic, swear it's so amazing. Yeah, I can't even lie, I feel like I just made it. Tell them check the numbers, man, you can't debate it. Don't talk about sage.
All right, so next one's a little bit harder, but it's behind the back to spin fade. Now, this is a little bit of a misdirection dribble, and a lot of times you can get a great look out of this to get the defense to slide out of the way first before you do a spin move into a jump shot. Now, the great part about this move is you don't have to shoot out of it. A lot of times this opens up nice passes, nice dump downs for your bigs, a lot of great looks. You don't necessarily have to shoot in it, but a lot of times you can embarrass the defender out of this one as well. So basically all it's gonna start with is a lateral behind the back. So as I'm driving this direction, I'm gonna put the ball behind my back, and I'm gonna try to sit low, almost like I'm sitting in a chair, right? So I got some nice space for the ball to go through. Now the key is, as I go behind the back, I'm gonna grab the ball with my opposite hand and then spin the opposite direction. Now you can put the ball back down for a dribble if you can make it happen. If not, you gotta pick it up and make a play from there. The whole key here is, as I'm getting down and I hit it behind the back, I wanna try to get him sliding by throwing my head, throwing my shoulders the opposite direction so he thinks I'm going that way. So now once I spin, I'm getting that extra separation, extra space. I can shoot, I can dump, I can kick, I can pass down the opposite block. I got a bunch of different options there, right? The whole key, ball control. Ball control and getting your eyes on rim as early as possible. As I come here and I hit it, it doesn't matter if I've got the best move in the world. If my eyes stay around here and I find the hoop at the last second, I'm probably gonna miss the jumper. Think about it like this. The longer you aim at something, the more accurate it's gonna be. So as I hit this behind the back and I go into a spin, I'm putting my chin on shoulder, finding the rim early with my eyes, so as I come through, I get a longer time to aim at it. You're gonna be able to hit more shots out of it doing that. So shift them with the behind the back, spin, eyes on target early for the jumper.
Don't talk about sage. I just started last May. Now I'm out getting paid. Tell them I need a raise. Get chips, no lays. All the guy be the praise. Now they out throwing shade.
All right, the next one up gets incredible results. It's the double hop or the skip to the hang cross. So it looks a little something like this. This is great to use in like transition or anytime you've got a little bit ahead of steam moving forward, or maybe you caught on the offense and you're a little bit further out than you normally would be. All we're gonna do is we're gonna do a little double hop or a skip on our opposite foot. So if I've got the ball in my right hand, I'm just gonna skip up on my left foot. Ball's in my right hand, skip on the left foot. If it's in my opposite hand, I'm doing the exact same thing, but opposite. Now the whole key is I'm trying to raise my shoulders, slow my tempo, and then drop as quick as I can and make it look like I'm exploding towards the basket. So as I come up, I'm gonna go skip, and then plant my shoulders this way so it makes it look like I'm attacking that direction, right? I'm trying to slide him there. So that's move number one, is the skip attack. Move number two, after I skip, I'm gonna hang where I'm throwing my head, throwing my shoulders, throwing the ball, and then cross over opposite. So basically, I'm trying to raise him up on D, get him to force to commit to run with me like this, and then I'm whipping a crossover going the opposite direction. This one's all about tempo and timing. You can't just do the whole thing super fast. You might wanna come up slow and then explode out of it going the opposite direction, right? It's all about tempo and it's all about timing. Now, one thing that helps, think about selling your eyes downhill when you go to do that cross. So as I come up and I skip, as I throw this plant, I'm gonna throw my eyes downhill, throw my shoulders. That makes it look like I'm going this direction. So when I whip it opposite, I got a lot more space to knock it down and really go by him. Got a girl on the line, she think I'm a man. Had no friends in school, funny now that y'all my fans. I'm the realest out, you more like a hologram. On the top floor and I do it. All right, now if you really wanna take your scoring to the next level, all you gotta do is click the top link description down below, and I put together a workout 100% free that's gonna help take your game to the next level, and it's gonna help you instantly increase your scoring average. That's how powerful it is. So go ahead, click the top link in the description down below, get 100% free access instantly. And if you're new to Shot Mechanics, hit that subscribe button, ding the bell notification, because YouTube's dumb and they're not gonna show you my videos for some reason, because entertainment's cooler than learning and getting better. But also, if this video helped you out, hit the like button, head to the comment section, let me know what sort of video you wanna see next. This is a channel for the people, by the people, and we run pretty much everything off a request, so leave it down below and hopefully I'll be able to get to it. Again, I'm Coach Colin Castell with Shot Mechanics Basketball. Thanks for watching, and until next time, splash on.